بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وأحسن الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. So inshallah we'll continue from where we left off last week, and the Sheikh was discussing the ninth nullifier of Al-Islam, the ninth matter that can nullify your Islam in the book, The Nullifiers of Islam, that we've been studying, the Sheikh has been explaining. And partially from last week, if you remember, the Sheikh was explaining that some of the people, they say that they are able to operate outside of the laws and regulations and the Sharia of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And one of the evidences they use, erroneously of course, is the encounter between Musa alayhi salam and Khadir. And as we know, this is mentioned in Surah Al-Kahf in the Quran, the story about Musa meeting Khadir, and they use this story incorrectly to justify them doing things or going outside of the scope of the Sharia that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with. And the Sheikh will explain inshallah further. So the Sheikh, he says, وَلِهَذَا جَاءَ فِي الْحَدِيثِ عَنْهُ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ أنه قال أعطيت خمسا لم يؤتهن نبي قبلي، وذكر منها عليه الصلاة والسلام أن كل نبي يبعث في قومه خاصة، قال وبعثت للناس كافة، فشريعته عليه الصلاة والسلام للعالمين، وكل أحد وجد بعد مبعثه عليه الصلاة والسلام لا يسعه أي شريعة إلا شريعته، لأنه بعث للعالمين وشريعته للعالمين. أما شريعة موسى عليه السلام فكانت خاصة بقومه بني إسرائيل، ولهذا كما سيأتي معنا لما التقى موسى عليه السلام بالخدر وعرفه بنفسه قال أنا موسى، قال له موسى بني إسرائيل، فمعروف في زمانهم أنه بعث عليه السلام في بني إسرائيل، فلا يمنع أن يكون هناك شرائع موجودة في بقع من الأرض أخرى بعث بها أنبياء أو باقين على دين أنبياء، بل ثمة قول قوي لأهل العلم أن الخضر نفسه عليه السلام نبي من أنبياء الله، والمسألة فيها خلاف معروف بين أهل العلم، لكن هناك قول قوي لجماعة كبيرة من أهل العلم أنه نبي وله شريعة خاصة بعث بها، كما أن موسى عليه السلام له شريعة خاصة بعث بها، والله قال في القرآن لكل جعلنا منكم شرعة ومنهاجا. So then the Sheikh mentions here, from continuing on from last week, He goes on to say, and he mentions a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ where it was mentioned, where the Prophet said, I have been given five that other prophets have not been given, that have preceded me. And the Shaykh mentions, and from that, as-salatu was-salam, he says that every prophet that was sent with a message or sent to the people, to its people or to their people, they were sent to their people specifically before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All the prophets beforehand, the prophets and messengers, the prophets were sent to their people, to their nations, to their people, specifically and only to them. However, as we know, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that I have been sent to the people, all of them. He sent to everybody. So when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent, he was not just sent to the Arabs, but he was sent to everybody. He sent to the Alameen, the mankind and jinn, everybody. And his Sharia, the law that he came with, alayhi salatu wasalam, it's for everybody, mankind and jinn. And that's what the Shaykh is mentioning here. And that nobody, after the sending of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, nobody can claim that they can operate outside of what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam came with. They just can't. Because of these evidences that we have in front of us. Then the Shaykh mentions, and he contrasts here, he says, as for the Sharia of Musa alayhi salam, then it was specific to the people, Bani Israel, to Bani Israel. And the Shaykh says, and this will come with us, and further explanation of this will be discussed later on in the lesson. And he says, when the Shaykh will mention, Hafidhullah, he'll mention the meeting between Musa alayhi salam and Khadir. And that, as we know in this story, that Musa introduces himself to Khadir and informs him. And Khadir, he says, I am Musa. And Khadir says in reply to him, are you the Musa of Bani Israel? This is what he says. So the Shaykh says it's well known in their time. It was well known that, you know, that Musa alayhi salam was sent to Bani Israel. It's known. This is the reason why Khadir said, Musa of Bani Israel. Is that the Musa that you are? So there's no blockade or prevention or a reason that there can't be, you know, more than one prophet or messenger being sent to two different nations, two different places, for example. This is what the Shaykh is saying. That could be in different lands, different messengers that Allah sends, prophets that Allah sends at the same time. Then the Shaykh continues and he says that these different legislations, the one that Khadir had and he was operating with, and the one that Musa had, two different ones, but they were operating under the revelation of Allah Jalla Wa'ala. Then the Shaykh goes on to say that it's well known amongst the people of knowledge, and it's well known that there's a group of people of knowledge, the scholars, they say that Khadir was not a prophet. But the Shaykh mentions that there is a group of the scholars, and there's a strong evidence as well with regards to that points towards the proof that Khadir was in fact a prophet and had his own Sharia that Allah gave him. And likewise, Musa had his own Sharia that Allah gave him. And then the Shaykh mentions an ayah from the Quran, from Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse 48, that we've given, in essence, that we've given you, all, like all these the messengers and the prophets, we've given you a legislation and a way to follow, each of you. We have given each of you a way to follow, and a Sharia, a laws, legislation, and a way to follow. Then the Shaykh continues, he says, فَهُوَ لَهُ شَرِيعَةٌ بَعَثَهُ اللَّهُ بِهَا وَمُوسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ لَهُ شِرَعَةٌ بَعَثَهُ اللَّهُ بِهَا فَكَيْفَ يَأْتِي هَؤُلَاءَ الْمُضِلُّونَ وَيَقُولُونَ يَسَعُنَا مَا وَسَى الْخَادِرِ الْخَادِرِ خَرَجَ عَنْ شَرِيعَةِ مُوسَى وَنَحْنُ نَخْرُجُ عَنْ شَرِيعَةِ مُحَمَّدٍ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ فَهَذَا مِنْ أَعْظَمِ الْفِرَقِ وأكبر الكذب وأفسد القياس وهو قول باطل وهو سبب لضلال هؤلاء وإضلالهم للناس عن دين الله وعن سواء السبيل. So then the Shaykh says that موسى was given laws and regulations that he followed from Allah, and likewise Khadr was given laws and regulations that he followed from Allah as well. So then the Sheikh says, so then how can those people say the misguided ones? How can those people say the misguided ones, and they say, oh, we're able to operate? They basically say we're able to operate outside of the laws and regulations that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with, because Khadr did the same thing when Musa, when he met Musa. This is the evidence they tried to use, obviously in a wrong way, because they have no proof really, and this is not really a proof for it doesn't make the case for their claim. And the Shaykh says, and that they say that Khadr, he operated outside the Sharia of Musa, and so likewise we're just doing the same thing, we're following what happened in the past there. And so we're operating outside the Sharia of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Shaykh says, so then this is from the greatest of lies, and lies that are being concocted from these misguided people, and it's the and the usage of evidence is also far away as well. It makes no sense to use that evidence for what they claim, absolutely no sense at all. And the Sheikh says this is the reason why they spread corruption and misguided the people, and the falsehood is spread in this way. And it's the reason why many people have been misguided with regards to this affair. And they block the people from the path of Allah, and they send them the wrong way. They divert them from the path of Allah Jalla wa'ala. This is what the Sheikh is saying. So he continues, he says, وقصة لقاء موسى عليه السلام بالخضر جاء ذكرها في القرآن الكريم في سورة الكهف، وأيضا ذكرها النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام كما في صحيح البخاري وغيره. يقول أبي بن كعب رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: قام موسى النبي عليه السلام خطيبا في بني إسرائيل فسئل أي الناس أعلم، فقال أنا أعلم، يعني أنا أعلم الناس، فأتب الله عليه إذا لم يرد العلم إليه، فأوحى الله إليه أن عبدا من عبادي بمجمع البحرين هو أعلم منك. وفي القرآن قال الله عز وجل: وإذ قال موسى لفتاه لا أبرح حتى أبلغ مجمع البحرين أو أمضي حقبا، إلى آخر السياق. قال هو أعلم منك، قال يا رب وكيف به؟ فقيل له احمل حوتا في مكتل، فإذا فقدته فهو ثم، متى فقدت الحوت فهو في المكان أو قريب من المكان الذي تفقد فيه الحوت. فانطلق بفتاه يوشع بن نون وحملا حوتا في مكتل، حتى كان عند الصخرة وضع رؤوسهما ونام، فانسل الحوت من المكتل فاتخذ سبيله في البحر سربا. وهذه آية من آيات الله، وجعلها الله علامة يهتدي من خلالها إلى مكان الخضر عليه السلام. وكان لموسى فتاه عجبا، فانطلق بقية ليلتهما ويومهما. فلما أصبح قال موسى لفتاه آتنا غداءنا لقد لقينا من سفرنا هذا نصبا. ولم يجد موسى مسا من النصب حتى جاوز المكان الذي أمر به، يعني الذي انسل فيه الحوت ودخل في الماء. فقال له فتاه أرأيت إذ أوينا إلى الصخرة فإني نسيت الحوت؟ قال موسى ذلك ما كنا نبغي، يعني هذا الذي جئنا لأجله، لأن هذه العلامة وضعها الله سبحانه وتعالى لموسى عليه السلام ليهتدي إلى المكان الذي فيه الخضر. قال ذلك ما كنا نبغي، فارتد على آثارهما قصصا. فلما انتهي إلى صخرة الرجل مسجى بثوب، وقال تسجى بثوبه يعني غطى نفسه بثوبه، فسلم موسى يعني ألقى السلام عليه، فقال الخضر وأن بأرضك السلام، بأرضك يقصد الأرض التي فيها موسى الآن، ولهذا جاء في بعض الروايات جاء بلفظ وأين في أرض السلام أو قريبا من هذه اللفظة، قال أن بأرضك السلام، من أين يوجد السلام. So we'll stop there for a second. I'll translate all that, inshallah. So the Shaykh, he says that the story of Musa alayhi salam in regard to Al-Khadir is mentioned in the Quran in Surah Al-Kahf, as mentioned before. And also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also narrated this story. And we can find this in Sahih al-Bukhari and other than it. Where Ubay ibn Ka'ab, may Allah be pleased with him, he narrated on the authority of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he narrated what we just read in Arabic. So if we translate this bit by bit, it's a long hadith, so we'll do it bit by bit, inshallah, as best as we can. Where Ubay ibn Ka'ab narrated to us that Allah's messenger said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Moses got up to deliver a sermon before Bani Israel, and he was asked, who is the most learned person among the people? Moses replied, I am the most learned. Allah then admonished Moses, for he did not ascribe all knowledge to Allah only. Then came the divine inspiration to him. Yes, one of our slaves at the junction of the two seas is more learned than you. Moses said, O my Lord, how can I meet him? Allah said, take a fish in a basket, and wherever the fish is lost, follow it. You will find him at that place. So Moses set out along with his attendant Yusha ibn Nun, and they carried with them a fish till they reached a rock and rested there. Moses put his head down and slept. Sufyan, a sub-narrator, said that somebody other than Amr said, at the rock there was a water spring called Al-Hayat, and none came in touch with its water but became alive. So some of the water of that spring fell over that fish, so it moved and slipped away out of the basket and entered the sea. When Moses woke up, he asked his attendant, bring our early meal. The narrator added, Moses did not suffer from fatigue except after he had passed the palace, the place he had been ordered to observe. His attendant, Yusha ibn Nun, said to him, do you remember what happened when we betook ourselves to the rock? I did indeed forget about the fish. The narrator added, so they came back retracing their steps, and then they found in the sea the way of the fish looking like a tunnel. So there was an astonishing event for his attendant, and there was a tunnel for the fish. When they reached the rock, they found a man covered with a garment. Moses greeted him. The man said, astonishingly, is there any such greeting in your land? Moses said, I am Moses. The man said, Moses of Bani Israel. Moses said, yes, and added, may I follow you so that you teach me something of the knowledge which you have been taught. So this is as far as where the Shaykh has said. So let's stop there. So the Shaykh, he continues, he says, وَهَذَا فِيهِ تَنْبِيهِ إِلَىٰ ذَلَالِ النَّاسِ وَانْحِرَافِهِمْ عَنْ دِينِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَىٰ فمع وجود الخضر بينهم قال وأن بأرضك السلام يعني من أين يأتي السلام مشيرا إلى الحال التي عليها الناس قال وأن بأرضك السلام فقال أنا موسى عرفه موسى عليه السلام بنفسه قال أنا موسى قال موسى بني إسرائيل قال نعم يعني موسى الذي بعث إلى بني إسرائيل قال نعم وهذا أيضا يوضح لنا ما سبق وأيضا يوضح لنا ما جاء في الحديث قال عليه الصلاة والسلام كل نبي يبعث في قومي خاصة وبعثت للناس كافة هذا مما أعطاه الله واختص به نبيه عليه الصلاة والسلام الأنبياء قبلهم كل نبي يبعث في قومه إلا نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم بعث للعالمين، بعث للناس كافة بشيرا ونذيرا. So then the Sheikh goes on to say that this is where people get misguided or with regards to the previous prophets and messengers, they were sent to their nations. Whereas the Prophet ﷺ was sent to everybody. And then he quotes this hadith here where the Prophet ﷺ said, every prophet was sent to his people or his nation specifically. However, I was sent to everybody. That the Prophet ﷺ was sent to everybody, not just his people, to everybody, to everyone. And this is what Allah has given to the Prophet ﷺ in regards to being sent to everybody. And he's the messenger of all of that exists, as in from the mankind and jinn. That he was sent to all of them and not to a specific nation only. And so this is what the Shaykh Hafizullah has mentioned here. So we'll continue with the story of Musa and Al-Khadir. So then the Shaykh says, فَقَالَ مُوسَى بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ قَالَ نَعَمْ قَالَ مُوسَى هَلْ أَتَّبِعُكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُعَلِّمَنِي مِمَّا عُلِّمْتَ رُشْدًا. So this is the part of the story where Khadir, when he gives salam to him, and Khadir replies and he says, who are you? And he says, I am Musa. And then Al-Khadir replies to him and says, are you the Musa of Bani Israel? And he says, yes. And then Musa asks Al-Khadir, can I follow you that I can learn some of the knowledge that you've been bestowed with from Allah? So then the Shaykh continues, says, in the Al-Khadir, ilm, laysa inda Musa, wa min ayna hadha al-ilm lil-Khadir, ataahu Allahu azza wa jalla min ladunhu ilma. وهذا من جملة ما استدل به أهل العلم على أنه نبي من أنبياء الله. ليس هناك آية أو حديث فيها التنصيص على نبوته، ولكن هناك قرائن وشواهد ودلائل يستفاد منها ذلك. ولهذا ذكرت أن ثمة قول قوي لجماعة من أهل العلم بنبوة الخضر عليه السلام وأنه من أنبياء الله، وإذا تقررت نبوته بالأدلة والشواهد من الكتاب والسنة، فهذا من الأمور التي يستفاد منها أيضا في إبطال الشبهة، لأنه نبي له وحي خاص، كما أن موسى نزل عليه وحي خاص، فموسى مأمور بالتزام الوحي الذي أنزل عليه، والخضر مأمور بالتزام الوحي الذي أنزل عليه، والخضر عنده علم ليس عند موسى مما علمه الله تبارك وتعالى إياه. So then the Sheikh goes on to say, he says that with Khidr is knowledge that Musa doesn't have, and likewise there's knowledge with Musa that Khidr does not have. And where did Khidr get this knowledge that Musa does not have, alayhi salam? It's, and the Shaykh says, because Allah Azza wa Jal bestowed that knowledge upon Khidr. And the Shaykh says, and this from a general perspective is the evidence that the people of knowledge, the scholars, they use as evidence to show and shows proof that Al-Khadir was in fact a prophet from the prophets of Allah Jalla wa Ala. And the Shaykh says there isn't a verse or a hadith that specifically states his prophethood, like straight up prophethood. However, by looking at these points and looking at the evidences, and looking at the situation as a whole, you can see, the Sheikh is just saying, you can see that a group from the people of knowledge, the scholars, have derived from these points that, in fact, Khidr is a prophet And he is from the prophets of Allah. And so the Shaykh just mentions this point to us here with regards to these some of the evidences that show us from a general perspective that Al-Khadir is a prophet of Allah Jalla wa'ala. And so, and as we know in the story, as the Shaykh will continue, as we know in the story that when Musa followed Al-Khadir, he did things, he did actions which Musa found distasteful, and then afterwards he explained to him why he did those. And so that shows that he received revelation and had knowledge that was specific to him, and he was carrying out orders from Allah Jalla wa'ala and had his specific Sharia. Likewise, Musa had his. This is also an evidence. So the Shaykh continues, he says, قال هل أتبعك على أن تعلمني مما علمت رشدا قال إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا يا موسى إني على علم من علم الله علمنيه لا تعلمه أنت وهذه الكلمة لو قالها شخص بعد مبعث النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام لو قال إني على علم من علم الله علمنيه الله لا يعلمه محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم هذا يكون كافرا ويكون مدعي دعوة كاذبة فاجرة قد قال عليه الصلاة والسلام كما في الصحيح إن أعلمكم بالله وأخشاكم لله أنا فليس هناك أحد أعلم بالله منه فهو أعلم عباد الله بالله وأعظمهم خشية لله وطاعة له سبحانه وتعالى فلو قال هذه الكلمة قائل أو ادعاها مدعي فهو كاذب فهي كفر لأن هذا تفلت من دين النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام ومن شريعته الناسخة للشرائع التي كانت قبل محمد صلوات الله وسلامه عليه أما الخضر قالها عن علم من الله جل وعلا آتاه الله إياه علمه الله إياه. So then continuing from where we left off, from where we were reading, the Shaykh, he goes on to say this part of the hadith that we're continuing, the long hadith. Al-Khadr said to him, O Moses, you have something of Allah's knowledge which Allah has taught you and which I do not know. And I have something of Allah's knowledge which Allah has taught me, which you do not know. Moses said, But I will follow you, Al-Khadr said. But I will follow you. And Al-Khadr said, Then if you follow me, ask me no question about anything until I myself speak to you concerning it. So that's where the Shaykh has stopped. So we'll continue translating what the Shaykh has said. So the Shaykh mentions here as well as an explanation for this. He says that, so if a person comes now, for instance, after the coming of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam comes now and says, look at the story of Al-Khadir and Musa, and so for that reason I can operate outside the laws and regulations that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with, then the Shaykh says that this is an outright lie. A lie and a distortion of the evidences, and that this, a person who says this is indeed a disbeliever in Islam and leaves the fold of Al-Islam. And also that if somebody says this, I can operate outside, then in fact, in one way, they're also saying that they know more than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They're saying that they have more knowledge than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Shaykh mentions a Sahih hadith here where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "The most knowledgeable and the most fearful of the most knowledgeable of Allah and the most fearful of Allah is I, as in is me, as in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam." So then, as we know from these evidences, then we know that there isn't a person more knowledgeable about Allah and more fearful of Allah than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's clear from this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sahih hadith. So if the person then goes and claims, makes these claims that they are more knowledgeable, that they have knowledge, that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was given X, Y, and Z, then in fact they leave the fold of Islam, and obviously clearly they're a liar. And this is an attack on our deen. it's an attack on the deen of Islam, the likes of these kinds of kind of rhetoric and the way and these kinds of things that the people say or that may be said. As we know that the Sharia of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and what he came with is an abrogator. It abrogates everything that came before it, and the Sharia that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will remain up until the establishment of the hour and the day of judgment. So then the Shaykh continues. He says, فَقَوْلُهُ لِمُوسَى إِنِّي عَلَى عِلْمٍ مِنْ عِلْمِ اللَّهِ عَلَّمَنِيهِ لَا تَعْلَمُهُ أَنْتَ وَأَنْتَ عَلَى عِلْمٍ عَلَّمَكَهُ لَا أَعْلَمُهُ هَذَا مِمَّا اسْتَدَلَّ بِهِ أَهْلَ الْعِلْمِ عَلَى أَنَّ مُوسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ لَهُ شَرِيعَةٌ وَعِلْمٌ مِنَ اللَّهِ عَلَّمَهُ اللَّهُ إِيَّاهُ والخضر له شريعة علمه الله سبحانه وتعالى إياها يعلمها موسى عليه السلام. So then the Shaykh continues with this hadith and he mentions the next sentence. He says, where Khadir says, indeed, I'm upon knowledge from Allah that Allah has taught me that you don't know. And likewise, you're upon knowledge that Allah has taught you that I don't know. And the Shaykh says that the scholars, the people of knowledge, they use this as evidence to show that Musa alayhi salam was on a specific Sharia that Allah sent him with, and Al-Khadir was upon a following a specific Sharia that Allah sent him with. And then he goes on to say, the Shaykh goes on to say, and he continues with this hadith, he says, قَالَ إِنِّي عَلَى عِلْمٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِ اللَّهِ عَلَّمَنِي لَا تَعْلَمُهُ أَنْتَ وَأَنْتَ عَلَى عِلْمٍ أَلَّمَكَهُ لَا أَعْلَمُهُ قال ستجدوني إن شاء الله صابرا وهذا فيه حرص موسى مع مكانته العظيمة وكونه كليم الله على العلم ورحلته في طلب العلم وحرصه عليه وتلقيه للعلم عمن هو دونه في الفضل لأن موسى عليه السلام أفضل من الخضر وهو من صفوة وأولي العزم من رسل الله وهم خمسة كما تقدم ومع ذلك رحل هذه الرحلة في طلب العلم وتحصيله على الخضر قال ستجدني إن شاء الله صابرا ولا أعصي لك أمرا فانطلق يمشيان على ساحل البحر ليس لهما سفينة يمشيان على الساحل ليس لهما سفينة يركبانها إلى الشط الآخر فمرت بهما سفينة فكلموهما أن يحملوهما فعرف الخضر عرف أصحاب السفينة الخضر فحملوه بغير نول يعني بدون مقابل فحملوهما بغير نول والنول هو العطاء فجاء عصفور فوقع على حرف السفينة فنقر نقرة أو نقرتين في البحر يعني أخذ بمنقاره نقرة أو نقرتين من البحر الواسع العريض فقال الخضر يا موسى ما نقص علمي وعلمك من علم الله إلا كنقرة هذا العصفور في البحر ومعلوم أن نقرة أو مخيط يغمس في البحر لا يخرج بشيء ولا ينقص من البحر شيئا. So then the Shaykh continues and he goes on and he continues to mention this hadith and narrate it. He says, after that, both of them proceeded along the seashore. There passed by them a boat whose crew recognized Al-Khadir and received them on board free of charge. So they both got on board. A sparrow came and sat on the edge of the boat and dipped its beak into the sea. Al-Khadir said to Moses, my knowledge and your knowledge and all the creation's knowledge compared to Allah's knowledge is not more than the water taken by this sparrow's beak. So this is up to the point where the Shaykh mentioned. So let's carry on reading. So then, so then the Shaykh mentions, he continues the story here and he says, then Moses was startled by Al-Khadir's action of taking an object, or it says here, adzi in this translation, and scuttling the boat. He basically scuttled the boat. with it. Moses said to him, these people gave us a free lift, but you intentionally scuttled their boat so us to drown them. So we'll just stop there for a second and continue with where the Sheikh's mentioning this. So the Sheikh, he continues, he says, قَالَ فَعَمِدَ الْخَضِرِ إِلَىٰ لَوْحٍ مِّنْ أَلْوَاحِ السَّفِينَةِ فَنَزَعَهُ أي خَرَقَ فِي, في سَفِينَةِ خَرْقًا جَعَلَ فِي السَّفِينَةِ عَيْبًا فَتَعَجَّبَ مُوسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ مِنْ هَذَا الصَّنِيعِ يعني هؤلاء أحسنوا إليهم ونقلوهم بدون نول ثم يعمد الخدر إلى لوح من السفينة وينزعه يعني يجعل في السفينة خرق فقال موسى قوم حملونا بغير نول عمدت إلى سفينتهم فخرقتها لتغرق أهلها قال ألم أقل إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا قال لا تؤاخذني بما نسيت يعني أن هذا الذي وقع من موسى كان عن نسياني للاتفاق الذي بينه وبين الخضر قال لا تؤاخذني بما نسيت يعني نسيت الاتفاق الذي دار بيننا قال فكانت الأولى من موسى نسيانا يعني نسى الاتفاق الذي دار بينهما فقال هذه الكلمة عليه السلام. So then the Sheikh he mentions here, he continues and he says then Moses said to him, these people gave us a free lift, but you intentionally scuttled their boat so as to drown them. Surely you have, you know, from Surah Al-Kahf verse 71 to the end of that verse. So then they both proceeded and found a boy playing with other boys. So then the Sheikh mentioned something here that's not within this translation, but I'll translate this as well on top of it. That the Sheikh mentions that Musa said to him, you know, such an act that you've committed in terms of sinking this boat. And then Khadir turned around and said to him that he said to him here, let's see where this is. So Musa said to him, فَقَالَ مُوسَى قَوْمٌ حَمَلُونَ بِغَيْرِ نَوْلٍ So you, these people gave us a free lift, as mentioned in the translation, and then you sank their ship, or had to, you put a hole in their ship, and they had to board or dock. And then Khadir said to him, didn't I say to you that you're not able to be patient with me? And then Musa alayhi salam replied to him and says, don't chastise me for what I've forgotten. And the Sheikh mentions here that this is the forgetfulness was to do with what they agreed upon on the start of the journey. That Musa alayhi salam wouldn't say anything of what he did up until Al-Khadir would explain to him all of the actions that he had done. So then the Sheikh continues, says, فانطلق فإذا غلام يلعب مع الغلمان فأخذ الخدر برأسه من أعلاه فاقتلع رأسه بيده غلام بين الغلمان جاء إليه الخدر ومسك رأسه واقتلعه من بدنه فقال موسى أقتلت نفسا زكية بغير نفس قال ألم أقول لك إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا في المرة الثانية اعتذر كما جاء في الآية بأنه لن يعود لمثل هذا قال إن سألتك عن شيء بعدها فلا تصاحبني قد بلغت من لدني عذرا يعني المرة الأولى اعتذر بالنسيان والمرة الثانية قال اعتبرها الأخيرة إن تكرر مني لا تصاحبني. So then the story continues. Then they both proceeded and found a boy playing with other boys. Al-Khadir took hold of him by the head and cut it off. Moses said to him, have you killed an innocent soul who has killed nobody? Surely you have done an illegal thing. As in the ayah of Surah Al-Kahf verse 74. Then he continues, he said, didn't I tell you that you will not be able to have patience with me But they refused to entertain. Okay, so this is the part of the story where the sheikhs mentioned up till this point. And where Khadir turns around and says, have I not told you that you will not be able to have patience with me of the actions that I'm doing? And then the sheikh brings an ayah here as well. And then, as we know, this ayah is well known, so refer to this yourselves, verse 76 from Surah Al-Kahf. And the sheikh says that this is the second time that Musa alayhi salam apologized to Al-Khadir about what he forgot of what they agreed upon, that he wouldn't ask him anything up until the point that Khadir would explain his actions to him. And then Al-Khadir said to him, as we know, that what came in the Quran as well in Surah Al-Kahf, Al-Khadir said to him that if you do it again, where Musa mentioned that if I do it again, then we'll part ways and I won't accompany you anymore. The Shaykh continues, فَانْتَلَقَ حَتَّى إِذَا أَتَيَا أَهْلَ قَرِيَةِ اسْتَطْعَمَا أَهْلُهَا فَأَبَوْا أَنْ يُذَيِّفُوهُمَا فَوَجَدَ فِيهَا جِدَارًا يُرِيدُ أَنْ يَنْقَدَّ فَأَقَامَهُ الْخَدِرْ بِيَدِهِ يعني باشر الخدر إقامة الجدار الذي أراد أن ينقض بيده مع أن القوم لم يذيفوهما فقال له موسى لو شئت لاتخذت عليه أجرا يعني تطلب منهم أجرا مقابل إقامتك لهذا الجدار قال هذا فراق بيني وبينك قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يرحمه الله موسى لوددنا لو صبر حتى يقص علينا من أمرهما يعني مزيدا من الأخبار قال يرحم الله موسى لوددنا لو صبر. So then the story continues and the sheikh, as he mentions here, he says that then they both proceeded and found a boy playing with other boys. Al-Khadir took hold of him by the head and cut it off. We mentioned this already. Moses said to him, have you killed an innocent soul who has killed nobody? Surely you have done an legal thing. Then it was said to him, didn't I tell you that you won't be able to have patience with me? Musa alayhi salam replied and says, at this point, if I do it again, then we'll part ways. If I forget again and I say anything again, we'll part ways. But then the story continues, but they refused to entertain. So then they came up to a place. They arrived at a place and the people lived there. And they refused to host them as guests and give them food or a drink. And there, Musa and Al-Khadr found a wall at the point of collapsing. There was a wall within that village or this place that they were in where the people didn't host them and they didn't give them food or drink. They found a wall that was about to collapse. And Al-Khadir moved his hand thus and set it upright. He basically repaired that wall. Musa alayhi salam said to him, when we entered this town, they neither gave us hospitality nor fed us. If you had wished, you could have taken wages for it. At that point, Al-Khadir turned around and said, this is the parting between you and me. This is where we part ways. And I will tell you the interpretation of those things about which you were unable to hold patience. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, we wish that Musa alayhi salam could have been more patient so that he, Allah, could have described to us more about this story. And Ibn Abbas used to recite, and in front ahead of them there was a king who used to seize every serviceable boat by force. And as for the boy, he was just a disbeliever. So as we know in this surah, the rest of the story. So then the sheikh, he continues and he says, The point that's being made here, he says, is that it says, أَنَّ هَذَا الَّذِي حَصَلَ لِلْخَدْرِ هَذَا عِلْمٌ لَدُنِّي مِنَ اللَّهِ آتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِنْ عِنْدِنَا وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّا عِلْمًا. So the point being made by the Shaykh here, Hafidhullah, is that he says that Al-Khadr, as mentioned in Surah Al-Kahf, Al-Khadr was given knowledge from Allah. Allah gave him knowledge. Yeah, that Musa did not have. So, And this and just a point that I think I may have forgotten to mention also is that, as we know, Musa alayhi salam is from the five mighty messengers, one of the five mighty messengers. And the Shaykh mentioned at the start, I forgot to mention this, I remember now, I'll mention it now, that even though Al-Khadir was not a mighty messenger, is not from the mighty messengers, and Musa is, we can see the humbleness of Musa alayhi salam here, where he wanted to follow him and learn knowledge that Allah had given him specifically, and which Musa did not have and Khadir had. So you can see this principle of seeking knowledge and humbling yourself and taking it from wherever you can find truthful and correct knowledge, and being and striving upon that way. So anyway, the Shaykh continues. He says, أخبر الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن أنه أتاه علما من لدنه وهو وحي من الله عليه فهو يعمل بوحي وهذه الأعمال التي استنكر موسى ظاهرها عليه السلام لما بين له الخضر بما أوحاه الله إليه الأسباب التي لأجلها فعل تلك الأفعال اتضح لموسى اتضح لموسى الأمر وأن أعمال الخضر كلها كانت على صواب وعلى سداد وعلى حق لكن ظاهرها كان عنده استنكار لها واعتراض عليها ولهذا كلم الخضر في كل موقف بما يتعلق بذلك الموقف لكن فيما بعد لما شرح له الخضر ونبأه بالأمور التي لم يستطع عليه السلام عليها صبرا تبين له الأمر. So then the Shaykh says in this paragraph that Al-Khadir was operating under the revelation and Sharia that he was given by Allah Jalla wa'ala. And so at those three points where Musa alayhi salam had stopped him and said things when he did particular actions where he put a hole in the ship so that they could dock because there was a leader or a person or a leader who was basically confiscating by force people's ships, taking them. There was a ruler that was forcefully confiscating people's ships. And as we know in the story, that was the reason why he docked them, because he knew that he was given knowledge by Allah that there was this ruler that was confiscating forcefully people's ships. So he did that. And then when he stopped the second time, where Musa stopped him and asked him about why did you kill that the kid, the young child, the young lad, why? And then when Khadir explained to him in the end, as we see, as we read in the Surah Al-Kahf, he explained to him that he was a disbeliever and I was an oppressor and he oppressed his parents. And then about the wall, when Musa stopped him and said he could have asked for a reward. And then he explained that as well to him, as we all are aware of in this story, which is mentioned in Surah Al-Kahf. Then the Shaykh mentions that he was operating under the Sharia that Allah sent him with, that Allah sent Khadr with. And that in the end, because Musa alayhi salam couldn't be patient upon some of these things that he was doing, then they parted ways. And before they parted ways, Al-Khadr explained why he did those things. The Shaykh says, فَشَاهِدْ أَنَّ الْخَدِرْ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ كَانَ يَعْمَلُ بِوَحْيٍ مُنَزَّلْ مِنَ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عليه مثل ما أن موسى عليه السلام كان يعمل بوحي منزل من الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وهذا الأمر حصل للخضر وكان في زمن موسى والخضر توفي عليه السلام مثل ما أن أيضا موسى توفي وجاء في حديث صحيح في حديث صحيح صريح أنهما من نفس منفوسة على وجه الأرض يعني في زمانه يأتي عليها مئة سنة مئة سنة إلا وتموت فلو قدر أن الخضر باقيا في زمن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام للازمه أن يأتيه وأن يأخذ عنه شريعته لأنه مثل ما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام لو كان موسى حيا ما وسعه إلا اتباعي وما هذا الحديث والدلائل الواضحة مع ذلك يدعي أقوام إلى الآن أن الخضر لهم وجود وأنهم يلتقون عنه مباشرة. وهذه أيضا طريقة من الطرائق ترويج أهل الباطل للباطل. فإذا قيل له من أين هذه الأمال، قال التقيت بالخضر، أو التقى شيخنا بالخضر وقال لنا كذا وكذا وهذا وكذا، هذا كله من الشيطان. وإن كانوا التقوا بشخص أخبرهم بأشياء فهو شيطان مريد أراد بهذه الطريقة أن يحرفهم ويسدهم عن سواء السبيل. So then in this final paragraph, the Sheikh mentions, summarizing it, the Sheikh mentions that that the people of misguidance, then they'll come and they say that Khadir is still alive and he's still around. This is what they say. And as we know clearly that everyone has a time that everybody will die, whether they're prophet or a messenger or not, whether they're prophet, messenger or not, they will die. They have an expiry. The people come with these lies, and he says some of these misguided individuals, they come with lies and they say that, we're taking directly from Khadr, this so-called knowledge. So they're coming with these doubts, and then they trick the people and misguide them by misleading them. Or they'll say, we're connected to our so-called sheikhs, and they have a connection with Khadr, who's still alive, and we're taking knowledge from him. But as we know from the hadith, from the last couple of lessons ago, where the Prophet ﷺ said, لو كان موسى حيا ما وسعه إلا اتباعي. As we know that when the Prophet ﷺ said, if Musa was alive, as in at the time of him, he was alive, he would have to follow me. And this is evidence again showing that the Prophet ﷺ's Sharia will be followed till the end of time, and nobody else can go out of it. As we know, at the end times, when Isa ﷺ descends from the heavens, he will follow the Sharia of the Prophet ﷺ. And that's another proof as well. So the Sheikh says that the people that come with these kinds of lies and they say, we got information from so-and-so, or we're getting directly from the Lawh al-Mahfuz, or we're getting revelation from Allah Jalla wa'ala, or we're getting revelation from Al-Khadir, or our Sheikhs who are connected with Khadir, or etc., all these lies. Then the Sheikh says, no, that basically this is from the Shaitan. These people are Shayateen, the devils, and they are receiving revelation from the devils, and they're misleading the people, and they are making them deviate and from the correct path, the path of Allah, and they are blocking them from the path of Allah Jalla Wala. This is what the Shaykh has mentioned. We've almost finished now, so a couple of paragraphs to go and we'll finish the lesson inshallah. So the Shaykh says, أشاهد أن من يقرأ قصة الخضر عليه السلام في القرآن في سورة الكهف ويقرأها في صحيح البخاري وغيره يدرك أن الذي كان عليه الخضر وحي من السماء أقره موسى عليه. أما بعد مبعث النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام، فمن ادعى أن عنده علم لدني يسعه به أن يخرج عن شريعة محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام مثل ما وسع الخضر فهو كافر خارج من ملة الإسلام. موسى عليه السلام أقر الخضر فيما وسعه من أمور ليست في شريعة موسى وحي وهي وحي من الله، وأقره موسى عليه السلام. أما نبينا عليه الصلاة والسلام أخبر أنه بعث للناس كافة، وأخبر أنه لا يسع أحد ولو كان نبيا من الأنبياء لا يسع بعد مبعثه أن يتبع غير شريعته. والخضر نفسه عليه السلام في زمن موسى كان يسع الخروج على شريعته، لكن لو قدر وجود الخبر وبقاء الخبر إلى زمن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام، فبعد مبعث النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام لا يسع أحد لا الخضر ولا موسى ولا غيرهما من أنبياء الله وصفوة الخلق، لا يسع أحد أن يتبع غير شريعة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. So then the Sheikh wraps up in this paragraph that whoever claims that they are able to operate outside the Sharia of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whoever they may be, then they by doing this, they leave the fold of Al-Islam. They become disbelievers. And the Sheikh mentions here as well that going back to the story of Al-Khadr and Musa, that Musa, you know, attested to the fact that Al-Khadr was upon knowledge from Allah that he did not have. He attested this. And this is a proof as well that it was attested. He attested this as a messenger himself, that Khadr had knowledge that he did not have, and they was operating under the Sharia of Allah, yeah, in a different place. And the Shaykh mentioned this here, and then he also says that, as the Prophet mentioned, that after the sending of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Sharia that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has come with, and that he came with, it abrogates everything else before it. Whatever the prophets and messengers had, it abrogates everything. And it's the Sharia that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with, by the permission of Allah jalla wa'ala, that will remain till the end of days. And there's several evidences already mentioned, and also in the previous three or four lessons with regard to this point as well. And the Shaykh mentions it again. Finally, the Shaykh, he continues and he says, finally, in the final paragraph, مَحْمَدْ دَعَى مُدَّعِي وَتَقَوَّلَ مُتَقَوِّلٌ قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْ وَأَيْضًا أُؤَكِّدُ أَلَى مَا سَبَقَ التَّنْبِيهَ عَلَيْهِ أَلَى وَهُوَ أَنَّ هَذِهِ الطَّرِيقَةَ أَصْبَحَتْ حِيلَةً مَاكِرَةً لِأَرْبَابِ الضَّلَالِ تَرْوِيجِ بَاطِلِهِمْ إِمَّا بدعوى أنهم التقوا بالخدر وأخذوا عنه تلك الأعمال أو بدعوى أنهم مثل الخدر يسعوا ما وسع الخدر وسعه أن يخرج عن شريعة موسى عليه السلام وادعوا لأنفسهم أنهم يسعهم أن يخرجوا عن شريعة محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام ومن اعتقد لأحد كائنا من كان أنه يسع الخروج عن شريعة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم كما وصل خادر الخروج عن شريعة موسى عليه السلام فهو كافر. فهذا الذي ذكره شيخ الإسلام قرره أهل العلم قبله واستشهدوا له بالشواهد العديدة ودلائل المتنوعة. So then the Sheikh, he finishes off with this and he mentions, he repeats some of the things he mentioned in the previous paragraph, but he brings an ayah from the Quran, which is Surah Ali Imran, verse 85, where Allah said, whoever wishes to follow a religion other than Al-Islam as a way of life and a religion, then it will never be accepted from him. And the end of the ayah says also, if we complete it, and that it'll be from the losers, that the person on this will be from the losers, that's on this path will be from the losers. So as we know, that the deen of Al-Islam, that is what Allah is happy with for us. Anything else is not accepted. And the Shaykh mentions this again here in the few lines that we read in Arabic, and he mentioned this in the previous paragraph, so I won't repeat this now, because we're running out of time. And then he says, وَنَقِفُ إِلَى هَذَا الْحَدِ وَاللَّهُ تَعَالَى أَعْلَمُ وصلى الله وسلم على عبده ورسوله نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين. So with that, we'll finish the lesson and we'll continue the last principle of this book next week. And inshallah, hopefully we'll be able to finish this book and then move on to another one. So inshallah, we will meet again next week. بإذن الله تعالى. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت وأستغفرك وأتوب إليك. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.